There's another concept that's been floating around on the internet about antibody-dependent enhancement. Could you explain what that is and if you think that's kind of relevant to this discussion about COVID-19 vaccines?
So, yes, it's actually unlike the sort of fertility story. This is something that at the beginning of the vaccine development pathway was taken very seriously, and all the trials were designed to find if there had been a problem with this. And for the vaccines that have been approved so far, there hasn't been. But what it is basically the idea that if you have an antibody response to something, and I'm going to give you the example of dengue hemorrhagic fever, because this is one of the places where we know that it does happen. So if you have an antibody response to a particular pathogen, and later on you meet a version of that pathogen that is sort of similar, but not quite the same, what can happen is that the antibodies that aren't quite good enough to wipe it out can cause it to be taken up by, for example, macrophages, which are a kind of immune cell that gobble up things, which allow it to be taken around the body and can cause the virus to spread. And so that does actually happen, for example, with dengue. And the reason it was potentially a concern for this virus was because we know that some of the animal coronaviruses, I think it's the feline enteric coronavirus, have been really difficult to design vaccines against, because whenever they do design a vaccine, the vaccine actually tends to cause antibody-dependent enhancement rather than wiping out the virus. So it was a potential concern when we were developing the vaccines. But the trials were designed to detect if vaccination gave you worse disease rather than protecting you from disease. And we see it really clearly that the vaccines protect you from disease rather than making the disease worse. So it seems that there's no antibody-dependent enhancement effect going on here.